she said I could use it to set up fights. And so what I'm planning to do is use my villager breeder and get a bunch of villagers over here. And I'm going to zombify them the way I do in my, in my villager hall. And I'm going to use that, okay, this is the arena right here. Boom, big, beautiful archway. She was also using this as a shop. Apparently someone robbed her chest because they thought she was gone like forever. She had been off for like a month and a half, but with a build like this, your land claim doesn't really go away. You're kinda here forever. This marvelous arena I am going to use to set up gladiator fights. I just need to build in some water elevators so we can get in and out. I need to transport zombies over here. And yeah, I just need to create baddies for it to fight and let people know that it's happening so they know that they can, ow. That was a thing. So yeah, I need to stockpile that. And then I also need to gather stuff for Phantom Isles. I made way too many shulker boxes. I made the shulker boxes so I could manage my inventory, but now my shulker boxes are like the majority of my inventory. Oh, so I also did a bunch of harvesting stuff for Phantom Isles last night off camera. I got about a double chest worth of warped wood or warped logs, whatever they're called, I guess. And right now I'm also in the process of gathering glass for Phantom Isles. I have no idea what this is gonna end up being, but it's pretty cool. It's gonna take a lot of end blocks though. I haven't actually been like collecting the end blocks from end cities or anything. But yeah, I contributed a little bit, which I think I actually have more on me that I can throw in here. Anyways, back to harvesting glass. I see you, go away. All right, got my first volunteer. Let's get this guy over to the arena. Okay, so if there are villagers already here, then I just need to build a zombifying system. Zombifying one of these jokers shouldn't be hard. I just have to get a zombie to spawn. I can move them very easily if I create a tunnel with a job block at the end of it, as long as it's within a certain radius, and that should deposit them into the armory. I'm gonna have to go back to base for like pistons and stuff. But if this is the armory, then we're also gonna need to create a system to allow them to go like out to, if we store zombies and stuff over here, how do we get them over here in like a controlled manner? Because I know it's possible to just like create a tunnel and it would look gross. Okay, and punching a hole through right here, and we'll put a lever on the side and an iron door, which for now is open. I know that's not an elegant solution to anything at all. Villager walks in here, goes over to armory. Yeah, it goes over to armory. Armory has job block for luring. Now, the problem is the armory, it's two-sided. There's guys over here and there's guys over there. Lure them in, get them zombified, and then just like run away from them while they chomp at you. It's not like an elegant solution, but you know, it works. So our options are either convert them over there and then just have zombies chase us, or convert them in the pen. I think it'll be safer to have like a zombie conversion room. Okay, so I think that's the way this is gonna go. Just a series of controlled rooms. So there's a couple ways I can get them from room to room. I think the easiest one will be just like push them with water. And I am going to need to make all of these doors double doors, which I think will solve more than one of my issues. Just making one an entrance door and one an exit door. Yeah. Nothing will be centered though, which is annoying, but whatever. The only way to really control zombie movement is to lure them manually, which is annoying, I will admit. So it might be more worthwhile to zombify them in the actual pens. I'll make a water elevator here and I can sort of coerce villagers in there. What I can do is I can lure them into a trap door, a little row of trap doors, and they'll be like, oh, I can walk over this. And I'll be like, no, you can't. and they'll fall down into a puddle of water. And that should be fine. So if this was a working cavern, it's definitely been abandoned for a while now. Okay, that leads directly to the arena. Yep, that is the base of the arena right there. Okay, so that's definitely a working cavern. Now I have to find a way back. Yeah, I think I'll just go back up top and then use the staircase from the top, because it's going to be very difficult to find this place properly. And I can find... Yeah, there's no possible way I was going to find this. The idea of this is to basically drop them down onto the water, and the water will carry them down to the arena floor, safe and sound. From here, convincing them to go to the arena floor might be a trick. It might be a tricky trick, and I'm not totally sure how I'm gonna do it, but I will find a way. Okay. Oof. No. Thank goodness protection works slightly on fire damage. Otherwise, I would have been out a lot of stuff. And that will just convince the villagers that there's not a drop right there. And so they will just waddle straight into the little corridor, I suppose. Actually, I might have to run villagers through this area in order to make the zombie fighters. I'll make a 3x3 holding pin here. Now I have to think about how I'm going to get them actually to go through this door. I'm thinking instead of doing like a big square area, I'll basically do like 3 chambers. I think that's going to be the plan. Okay, problem. The activator rail will, it'll release the minecart. Like the minecart goes over it, the minecart goes over it and it breaks. Like, or it doesn't break. It just throws whatever is in it out of it. That might not be a problem actually. So what I can do is I can make this area completely... Okay, I got it. So I'm going to make this area completely separate from the others. And the only thing this room is going to do is look out into the arena. And I'm going to make a little piston door right here. It's been a minute since I made a piston door, so that's going to take me a while. And I'm just going to drop off the people through like a 1x1, and they're just gonna go like whoop and go through the activator, which will just always be on, and that's fine. I think this is gonna work perfectly, and then we can just have like a series of tunnels that all lead to this. All right, this is containing zombies. Okay, zombies go here. Where are those iron bars? Oh, they're back. I should move those shulker boxes closer. Why do I keep running back and forth for my shulkers? And now let's take these shulkers over to my work area, because running back and forth is really dumb. The minecarts will be able to go into there, and they won't be able to come back. And that will be perfect. Okay. And we're back. Hi, guys. I guess in order to effectively get these jerks where I want them, I should do like a little squiggle. I can't squiggle it that way. Looks a little bit like there's spaghetti on the floor, but hey, it's functional. It's not pretty. So sometimes you just need things to work. Okay, so yeah, I know that looks like spaghetti, but it has to actually run into the mob for them to get on it. So the more ground you cover with the tracks, the more likely it is to successfully pick up whatever it is you want it to pick it up. Ooh, if I want to get kind of fancy with it, I can throw the activator right there. So that'll be powered and it'll kick them out right there. And then the minecart can come back toward here. I don't want it to connect to that. I want it to run into a cactus, and that way it'll break and it'll feed the part right back into the dispenser, and that way we won't have to restock dispensers ever. I mean, this isn't supposed to be a presentation area anyways. It's literally the only part that people should be able to see is ended like right here. So if there's a way to I need to find a way to hide this stuff a bit more, which should be easy because I'm gonna create a door right here that will open and close, and when it opens it'll just be like, yeah, release all the things. Okay, cool. Perfect. And that actually makes it so I don't need to power this rail at all. It just kind of goes by itself. So that's perfect. Okay. And it goes around, hopefully picks off a mob and dumps them over there, and boom. I should have counted, or I should have watched hoppers. All right, so it's going, and yep, works perfectly. Beautiful. Okay. Actually, you know what? Before I get too crazy with this, let's get zombies here. Let's actually effectively get some zombies in place. And they're all sleeping, because of course they are. Why not? By the way, for all the people in the comments who are going to be like, this is really noobish redstone. Yeah, it is. I never claimed to be great with redstone. Sort of making it up as I go along. I know some of the simple principles. I know that you can make different logic gates that require different types of input or whatever. I don't know how to use those effectively in any shape or manner. So I just kind of, you know, make it up as I go along. Oh, sweet. The cactus has already grown another level. If we get one more level out of it, we can harvest it and use it to break all of our minecarts. Okay, cool. Now it's just a matter of actually putting the mobs in the cages. Oh, wait. I forgot something kind of important. It won't be the nice line I was hoping it would be, but whatever.
Oh, wait, I'm being dumb, aren't I?
Yeah, I can just put the torches underneath. I don't know why I keep forgetting I can do that. So now we just need to get mobs into those cages. Let's start with the easy ones. I just realized something. I need to replace this with something less ridiculous. I should just like make a tower. I'll worry about that later, but I'll probably just like make a redstone dust tower that links to this. That way it can be controlled from up there, so no one has to come down to this super ugly room and control it. Then again, I'll have to come down to this room to restock mobs anyways. So I guess what I really should do instead of having a water system here, because I really should just have these rails go all the way to the top. There's no reason for it not to. Whatever, it works. It works. It's not perfect, but it works. Okay, the villagers can see the zombies and they're freaking out. But for whatever reason, the zombies can't see the villagers? It might be a bit tricky to get some of these guys into the arena, and the generic looking zombies are going to despawn. That will definitely happen at some point. But we have some villagers zombified for the arena. Now we just need cave spiders and we need skeletons. I got the zombies taken care of, and I think I'm gonna call that successful for now, because zombies are really gonna be the big attraction, because everyone wants to fight like a kitted out zombie. I think I'm going to call this a day. Thank you all so much for joining me. My name's Jeff.